Hello everyone, my name is Patrick Pomelo. Today I want to show you some new improvement with the new NestDrop version 2.0. So I will start with the Classic, then the Midnight, and the new NestDrop Midnight Pro. So the first thing you should notice is how much faster it's going to load. You see the number of presets here. We use mainly 40,000 presets right now, and it takes a few seconds to load all of them. And it's still very smooth and very responsive. The other thing you should notice is now as soon as you're loading, it will show you the last preset used and also show you the name of the preset into the video deck. Now you can change the BPM with the right click with your mouse. So now you can enter it a new number with the keyboard, or you can use the mouse wheel to just scroll all those numbers up and down. And when you select the right number, you just click on the background. You can do the same with the beat threshold. Change the number way above 64 limits, which was before. What else we change? Also the settings. We had a few more slider, like the wrap speed and horizontal motion, vertical motion. Those are pretty cool on some preset, like for example this one. So if I move horizontally with zwing, yui, or vertically, stretch speed, yeah. Wave mode, it changed wave you can use. So now there's 16 different wave, thanks to one of our followers to supply the code for this 8 additional waveform. The other change, we now set all settings into sections, so you can collapse the sections you want to show or not. Also, the video deck can be topmost or not. We have also a general feature in audio section. Now, if you have audio with only one active channel, just like the left or right channel, you can select the left channel and now it is duplicate to the right, so it's become mono. You can also change from bass, mid, treble action, just like this one is. The globe is pumping with the bass, so if I remove the bass, it stops pumping. Also, the cloud is blinking with the hide, the mid. So if I remove the mid, now it stops blinking. I can put back the bass on. Now it, of course, is saturated. So if you want to record those settings for a particular preset in a curve window, just drag and drop one of those settings. So every time I will activate this one, change the slider to this setting, the particular setting. And then when you play another preset, it will keep it like this, but free to you to put it back to the default one. There's also some other feature that we'll explain later on other videos. The NestDrop Midnight is essentially the same as the NestDrop Classic. You have also a color and a strobe section. The color section is add more feature that was before with the preset settings. Well, negative will inverse the color, brightness, contrast, gamma. So U shift, it will change the color. Saturation, it will put it in black and white. And Luma key, it will, all the white here is become transparent. And here all the black will become transparent. You can also change the red, blue, and green, change the alpha. The strobe LFO, it's for low frequency oscillator. So by default, the strobe do solid color white. So you just trigger. Now it's set to 1 per second. So it's the rate is 1. If you want faster, you can go up to 30 flash per second. So this one is to change the pulse width. Here is very narrow and here is pretty fat. You can also change the waveform from square to sawtooth or sine wave. instead of flash per second, you can change it per beat. And the effect limit is if you want full white or you want just halfway of gray, for example, you can change the color here. You just right left click and you can change to any color you want. Also, you can, instead of just solid color, you can choose all those parameters you want to associate it to. For example, animation speed. So for this one, the animation speed, change the size of the globe. Yeah, you say on, off. If you select sawtooth, it will slowly change the shape of the sphere. Or you can change to sign, it just more oscillates from bigger and smaller. You can change horizontal motion here pretty fast, but just do it one per second. You just move horizontal, change once per second. So that's it. And also, if you want to set this, drop this, and when you will click on this one, it will start the strobe using the setting you just set. There's also some other feature that we'll explain later on other videos. The Midnight Pro is mostly exactly the same as the Midnight is. What is more is you can use NDI output, click enable. You can also have this small OSC tab here. You just click any of the slider or button you want to control, and you have the full path here and the range to adjust in your standard device. Or you can also click on those tab to see what is the correct path. Activate those hotkey. In the general tab, now you have access to the SEO driver. You can choose which channel you want to use. And finally, the other feature is the Ableton link. You can check the link, and now you have the link with one peer. Soon as you change the BPM here, it will change in NestDrop. Or you can change BPM here, it will change into the residue. So that's it. There's also other features, but I will bring other videos showing more interesting facts. Thank you.